Hello, everybody. Super late on that countdown, my bad. I was over at the window taking care of some business, and I looked over and saw a countdown from five, and I was like, uh-oh. So, we're going to have a delayed start tonight. Not in terms of, like, I'm about to leave, but, I got an offline sub from none other than Sane TBD himself. What? So, what it also means is that we're at a number that's divisible by three. So it's a jelly bean. So I'm gonna go alert my Discord. Let everybody know. Boom. Okay. Everyone's been alerted. Everybody knows it's bean o'clock. Tree's already here, ready for it. Satan's here, ready for it. Oh, great. Well, give me 1 second. Prep myself. Oh, I gotta clean that lamp out. Oh, that is dust particles and probably some dead insects in there. That's disgusting. Just noticing that today. Yuck. Woo-ha! Had this baby sitting in the back of the fridge and I almost forgot. The last one. My last worship doom. Broman brains. Broman brains. All it is Roman Reigns fucking banging Braun Breaker. That's horrid. Oh. Yo, so I'm fucking shocked. I'm gonna have to send him an email after we're done tonight. But Sane TBD, who obviously uses a lot of my clips. I send him the clips because he doesn't want to use them without permission, which it's fair, I guess. Very down-to-earth guy. And I opened up my OBS. In the top left-hand corner is the activity feed, and it tells me when someone's on a sound alert, a cheer, a follow, a sub, whatever. And I just open up Stream OBS and I see the blue star and I'm like, who subbed last? I don't remember. And I was like, I think it was Tree, but that was a resub. And I look back and it says TBD Sane. And I was like, oh shit. Because I know in Twitch it's reversed for whatever reason. Because I remember he said he followed me. Subscribed for 6 months at tier one. Bruh, what? Excuse me. So, anyways, that is a divisible by three bean. So we gotta eat a bean now. Give it back. For what? He can absolutely use any of my clips, like, without my permission. He can grab something absolutely hysterical. It's fine. I consider it publicity. Alright, let's see. We're getting low. I think we have... Actually, let me see if I can count. The beans, not if I can just count in general. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, maybe 15? Giving back the beans. Oh. Oh, and Diz told me he bought a bag of these and he tried a Carolina Reaper and a jalapeno and he liked both of them. I'm like, fucking madman. Alright, what do we got tonight? Let's find out. I think that's going to be cayenne, my friends. Excuse me. Alexa, turn the office light to white. No, I think it's a sriracha. I think I lucked out. I don't see any black speckles on it. Yeah, I think it's a sriracha. Holy shit. Oh, butt cheeks here in the house. Fabinaro. Oh my god, so pale. Okay. Alexa, change office light to red. There, now we're back to normal. Quick shout out to the man. Since he's here. Turn the music down.
Where?
Oh, fudge! Fuck! Dude, what the
fuck game is that? So rosy and purdy. Bro, what game was that? That scared the shit out of me. And I was like, and I knew that was coming anyways. God damn. Okay. Like I said, it's bean time. So this one's the same TBD, the bastard. He didn't realize he was doing it. Fortunately, it's sriracha. It's one of the easier ones. Stuck to my teeth all the time. Oh, there it goes. Ah, you're welcome. Oh my god. I need a tissue. This one doesn't hurt, but it makes my nose run. Huh. I can't remember the game, damn it. That's amazing. I grabbed a clip from your clip library, so it's gotta be in there. So as long as it was labeled right, sweet dreams are made of beans, who am I to disagree? Tell you what, I had some very, very sweet dreams Saturday into Sunday morning. Jesus Christ. Anybody miss that madness from Saturday night? The most outrageous stream I've ever had. I ate 8 beans, drank like 10 beers. I think I had 2 or 3 shots of whiskey at some point. And that was a mistake because I had come home from a date night with the wife and I drank a whole bottle of wine. Like, okay, it's fine. Like, I was good, but it's like the foundation's built. Like, that's it. And everything came down afterwards, and holy Christ, that we played, we were playing The Shore, and I apparently was only 5 minutes shy of ending it and had no idea, which is too bad, but, and we had 2 different hype trains. It was off the fucking rails, man. Highly recommend going back and watching the VOD, and I'll eventually get all these VODs uploaded to YouTube. I'm just slow and fucking, Yes, awesome indeed. Tonight, just a little bit more, sorry. I installed a ton of games that I really wanted to play since we kind of ran through the backlog, what was there from Jugtober of last year. So now we have a new backlog. Let me think. Because I want to call in a vote, because honestly, I'm just curious. But since most people won't know the names of these games, or they do because they've played them and they're like, oh, let's watch Jugg fucking shit himself, I'm just going to give you some numbers, and you're going to pick whatever number you want to pick. And I'm just going to write the legend of what game's going to be what. We'll do that. Ooh. What in the fuck? Alright, it's gonna be four different games that I have set up just today. Now, let's go do a quick poll on it. Okay, new poll. Pick a number, any number. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so everyone gets one vote. You got 1 minute. At the top of the chat, you'll see the poll start to come by in a second here. You press it and then answer it. Or if you missed it or you can't see it because I think the mobile app is stupid, then just say it in chat. Just give me a number, 1 through 4. We got a vote for number 2. That's not good. Because that was one of the scary games I picked. 3's awesome. Oh shit, yo. Thanks for the bits, my friend. Appreciate you. Vote for 3? Alright, we got more than 2 people in here. Come on. Vote, damn it. No. I forgot about that again. Please don't. We have a tie at the moment. And no one else has given a vote. So yeah. This is what the votes were for tonight. So we have a tie between Infliction and Darkwood. Interesting choices. They go very different ways. Oh? Infliction. Great. Well, I redact my 3 vote. Oh my god. Fine. Infliction it is. Thanks to Tree. Infliction. Boom. Done. We have updated that. And I need to go and make sure that the game is on the right sound settings. I know it's a process. Oh, that's right. That's this weekend. Well, not this weekend, but tomorrow. God, I wish it was the weekend already. Anywho, this needs to go here. Must be a click in this game to hear sound shit. So, we'll go ahead and kill off this. Excuse me. Alright, cool, Jesus. Oh great, epileptic seizure, fucking stuff. Okay, let me get over to here because I haven't set this up yet because I'm silly. Game capture. Quick little switch to Infliction. We're not missing anything. It's like the intro videos for like the developers and stuff. Okay. I've heard very, very bad things about this game, like, but in a good way. Can I calm your titties? Oh, even the menu's scary. that's good. I gotta get down to my resolution that makes sense for me. Don't let it be. Actually, I don't know why it looks so gross. I'm not a fan. How do I revert that change? Fuck. Did anybody know what it was before? Was it 2560-1440? Why did OBS come all the way over here? This fucking thing. Kick it on medium for everything. Ooh, no. Or as low as I can get. V-Sync's already on, as Satan has let us know. Subtitles are always on, because it's nice. No anti-aliasing method. I don't like this at all already, so that's great. Movement, menu, crouch, use, or action, flashlight, zoom, interact, look. All right, well, pretty straightforward. I like that. I'm sorry. Get off the TV. Maximum V-Sync. Well, here goes nothing. Oh, finally, a game that actually auto-saves. That's so nice, because Trenches didn't do that to me last night. No checkpoint. There was one checkpoint after you get through the tutorial of the game. Great. So thankful for that. 7 out of 9, and that fucker crashed. Split between places. Here there can be only sadness and resolution. This is where the lost are found, and vengeance rears its ugly head. Vengeful souls are born of violent death. Necronomicon, Abaddon, Volume the Third. I like how there's subtitles for the... Yeah, okay. We also...
We've got some news hot off the presses. This station has received reports that the two lighthouse keepers from Oxford Point Island Lighthouse have vanished. The lighthouse keepers work...
You have one unheard message.
The lighthouse keepers have vanished.
The first unheard message.
Hi, baby. I'm stuck at the gate and they won't let me through. When you get back home, can you look for my ticket? I must have left them behind. Have a good look around and let me know. Love you. See you soon.
End of message. To delete this message,
so I'm just heading home.
It looks like they were halfway through dinner when something interrupted them. There were no signs of a struggle and all their belongings were still there, including a journal kept by one of them. The journal states several times that the island was talking to them. The most common theory is that the men have suffered from cabin fever and were perhaps accidentally washed out to sea. Other cases like this have been reported on in the past, but have never been fully resolved. A full investigation has begun into this bizarre case. We'll update you as the story progresses.
I think Seven was mostly lucky. I happened to find that fifth one and I was like, we're good. Oh, great. Yeah, this isn't, you know, late at all. I had to click it. Check out the gameplay in the menu to view tutorials. Oh, great. Oh. Okay. Yeah, there's definitely some Silent Hill vibes here. Hey, wait a minute. This is the car that we just definitely saw in that crash, and the cop was behind it. Learn how to crouch. Game audio down a smidge. Sure. I don't know why I just went over here, because I have it on Touch Portal. I'm really smart. Oh, wrong button. Ah. Close it, because you know this is my house. absolutely not have found a safe thing about to happen with the lumber hanging up in the car. It's funny. For a second, I thought the same thing. Okay, I guess I don't have my own keys. Don't like this at all. Back door, see if it's unlocked like a fucking freak. Yep. Great. If I just did that, who else is here? We got some crunchy wheat. I don't like how things are wigging out in the distance like that because the lighting. It's dumb. If I had to go pick that up, it's just the shine. No, it's actually... No, I don't think they're going to interact with them. Okay.
That's a big box. What is it? Wow, nice wrapping skills. Oh my god, a puppy. I can't believe you did this. I love her. I'm going to call you Sally. Okay. Now it's time for your gift.
I'm about to read the flashing note on the fridge. I'm getting there.
Look how clever our little girl is. I'm not sure exactly what's going on here, but she can already draw better
arrow,
than I can.
Paranormal.
She takes after her daddy.
June 1999. Look at that. That's shiny. I couldn't read that. Christ, the lighting's just really weird in this game for some reason. There might be TTS involved with this. The fuck is that?
You'll be lurking, my god. I have some games to get to as well.
Oh, well, thank you. I appreciate you for dropping by in the bits. It's very kind of you. Is that me walking on the carpet? Ooh, very sensual. Nothing to zoom at in here, huh? Oh, this right here. Behind the Black Veil 7. Oh, one of my favorites.
Yeah, it's the juggernaut, bitch!
I can't. Let's whisper saxophone. Thank you for the bits, man. V-Sync is on, yes.
Careless Whisper Saxophone.
I got you a present. Behind the Black Veil 7. Just don't expect me to watch it with you. I know you love this horror stuff, but it gives me nightmares. Ghosts? Yuck.
Starring Billy Bob Austin. Miranda Moore. She is home. And she is pissed. Amazing. There's also A New Hope and The Empire Strikes Back, Tales from the Crypt, X-Files Season 1, Gummy Bears and DuckTales. Behind Enemy Lines. Alright, cool. I appreciate the detail you just put into that. Look at these fucking masks. Is that m'lady? Oh, that must be me. It's definitely what I look like.
Do you, Sarah Angel Adage, take Gary Ryan Pout to be your lawfully wedded
Gary
husband?
Gary Pout.
To have and to hold from this day forward, for better. For worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health. until death do you part.
I do.
Okay. Good, no one was right behind me, because I kind of had a feeling that's when they were going to do it. Oof. That light works. Movement. I mean, yes, I'm moving, so. It's me walking on the carpet. It's a really weird noise. Can't open my own fucking shit, huh? What? Is this my house or somebody else's house? What is this? Do you have a similar photo above your fireplace? I do not, because I don't have a fireplace. Well, let me tell you. Tell me you're going to be the one to die in the car crash, and she has to investigate why it happened. I mean, that's what I'm gathering.
Friday, June 4th, 4:15 p.m.
June 4th.
Earlier asking about changing the code to your security door. All you need to do is enter the code, follow the steps I told you on the day I installed it. I wrote the code on the back of my business card. If you have any problems, call me during business
hours. It's not
045,
I'm stopping.
Through it. Thanks. It's Mike.
This to-do list? I'll make about how to change the code. Damn it. Lighthouse mystery. Vanished from lighthouse. Oh yeah, we heard about that. Lumber mill reopens after 12 years. Yeah, good for them. What do you mean it's an answering machine? It is 1999 here. What am I looking at? W selector? What the fuck is this thing? Should I take this or something? What in the fuck? Oh, this is wild. A fucking organizer with a little thing on it? Yeah, no, I know it's an address book now, but I've never seen one look like that before. Okay, well, now that I know what that is. Oh, maybe I have to get that dude's phone number. What was his name again? That happened real suddenly. I think she's hunting ghosts of her own. That door's open. Considering how the rest of my house looks, this is sus. If it's not closed and locked. What only he takes okay about the doors, but he won't worry about the fucking light bulbs. How do you fucking live like this? You should get in the car and drive away like a maniac and crash through a tree. Is this a house or a hotel? Both. Maybe. Rotate it. Doesn't really do anything else. You're the biggest fucking prick. Oh my god. Oh. Oh. I'm pretty sure my ass just left the seat by like the most microscopic amount, but I felt like I was free falling for a tenth of a second. Oh my god. I took 5 years off my life. Oh, just yours. I should do on the 4th of July stream the only bits that you can put through. I mean, the sound alerts. The only sound alerts you can use are gunshots and fireworks. Excuse me. Fucking Electro Man.
Don't be afraid. I'm only going out for 2 hours. If Maggie can't sleep, just read her this book. It works every time.
No, I just have the right audio setting.
Dinner's in the oven. Love you.
Poppy was the happiest unicorn in the world, but she had no unicorn friends. She felt different. Turn the page. Birds have beaks and sing songs that go cheap. Cows have horns and say moo. Mice are tiny, very quick and small. Sheep are fluffy, all covered in wool. Nothing even rhymes. Rabbits have big ears and bounce boing. Pigs are pink and have a snout. Skunks are black and white and can't take flight. Okay, that kind of rhymed. But everyone is different. Let's all be friends. Well, that's a nice story. I swear I'm going to turn around and someone's just going to be staring at me. My first piggy bank? Oh, stop it. Kablam. I left clicked that and I didn't expect it to actually move. I know how scary that just probably, you know, looked, and I didn't react to it, but there's a reason. Okay, sir. Thank you for the bits. God, get me the fuck out of this game. I would have much rather played Darkwood. Oh, good, a hiding place. I'm sorry. A numbered key lock on my own door in my house? This must be a hotel with one bathroom. Oh, Lord. Clean your shit. Quack. Antibacterial toilet cleaner. Oh, I was hoping it'd be something silly on the back of this. They actually legit wrote. It's gonna be a Rosemary's Baby situation. Probably. You can really pick up a lot of stuff in here. Yeah, I got scared by a fucking toilet. Leave me alone. Where was that sound even coming from? It sounded like it was all over the place. Oh, we gotta see what band she's repping. The Phantom Cult. There's an oh. Yo, let me in? I mean, like, if it was the let the right ones in, that'd be pretty cool, because that's the OG one. Madam Butterfly. Yeah, it looks like a cock rock band with Aleister Black in it. Okay. It's Olivia's room. Oh, here's Kurt Cobain if he didn't kill himself. Stage is my home, the fans my drug. Oh god, this is like the mixture of Avril Lavigne in Evanescence. And that's Twilight. Vampire High. Oh my god. This is great. I appreciate this room for what they did with it. What did I just do? I can hide under here? I didn't realize I was pressing E by accident. I didn't realize I could do that. I thought I just triggered a video sequence, and I'm like, oh. Okay. there someone upstairs? Oh, fucking kid locked this shit up. Yo, check out the fucking Nintendo. Gee, I wonder why they give you the option to hide under there. Gee, I don't know. All of our shit is locked. What is that all about? It's literally Olivia's room. It has empty plates. Artie Group London. Thimble Park. Never good. Madam Butterfly Apocalypse. Skulls and Roses. Gone Home. Carnival. Exile. Mass Effect. Oh, so I could turn it off and on or something. That's pretty cool. Sorry, where's the... That's not the VCR. Where's the VCR? Alright, I'm just going to disregard that. Pleasant Falls Rockfest. She loves them Skulls and Roses. Cheesy Pete, Clown Crew, Death Incarnate, Cisco, Bass-Ass Bears, Rocket Fuel, Hair, Cleo's, Death, Murder, Mayhem, The Sickness, and Dire Sun. What's up? Is the VCR above it? Oh, I didn't even see it. Oh, X-Files Season 1, let's go. What's good, Demon? How'd your stream go, my guy? Stupid. I don't know what the fucking code. The fucking code's gonna be. This is fucking bullshit. Yo, what? 0451. I'm not trying it. Can I fucking leave? Shit. Well, to see I'm terrified is a fucking understatement. Wait, no, come on.
God, baby, it's perfect.
Hey, Star.
Yes, yes, I will. I love you, Gary.
Oh, yeah, the hot mic, yeah. Really quick, sorry. I want to give some shout-outs to friends. Gary. First up, the incomparable. Oh, God.
Bad. Whatever the hell you're supposed to be. Oh, you bitch. You got me caught.
Oh, those games. And then, of course, how can we forget? Getting close to the Rickroll, very nice. Yo! Rage, what's up? Team killing clip, gotta love it. Alright. I don't wanna do this anymore. Pleasant Falls security doors. Oh! Oh, it was close. 0516. With a nice bathroom, it looks like. What the fuck? definitely 0516. We know that. 0516. No, I don't want to turn the water on. Pills of these. Can't even read it. Glare's too weird. Kill zone teammate. 0516. Thank you. It's the person showering the super nice house. Honestly, I have no idea. Can we stop? Thank you. 0516. I'm gonna try this door with 0516 first. If that doesn't work, then the front door I can change. Or I think I can change. Oh, 516. It did work. Nice. Oh, thank Christ. Oh, I'm safe in my office. Maggie Pout, for perfect attendance record and exceptional classroom participation, you are shining an example to your peers. Keep up the amazing work in the years to come. Amazing. Look at that fucking thing. That actually took me back. I was like, whoa. But it's like, I mean, we just were in her fucking room. We saw what she did. Or what she music she was into and stuff. Like, there's nothing wrong with that. That's what she's into. Honestly, great fucking work. We found the airline tickets. From Seattle to Sydney? Let's go.
Oh, it's
Jesus Christ almighty. Welcome, Fry. Oh. Thank you so much for the raid. Good Lord. Did you have any interesting run-ins this evening? Why? Why are you doing the music like that? Why? Sure did. Printers on? I remember those old printers. Palphonics? Dr. Cow sugar-free gum. Yogurt wrap. $56K modem, let's go. Alright, so we're gonna get jump scared. It's gonna happen, I'm not gonna be ready for it. It's gonna hurt. What are we? I even sucked over the TV.
Hang on, what are you doing? What's with the mask?
To the game thing, honestly, it all of a sudden looks like it. The clock says you're gonna miss your flight. I think you're right. Get the hell out of here, get in your car and leave. Optional objectives. Let's just go. We're done. We're fucking done here. Quick, what's the number, guys? What? Thank you for, yeah, it wouldn't let me press the buttons. We're fucking out of here. I think not. Go. This is when we die. Oh no. I knew it was the car, but I didn't realize that we killed our wife. Holy shit. Yo. Yeah, the second I saw the car, I was like, we just saw this car crash on the side road with the cop car next to it. Like, what the fuck? And I was like, maybe they're just reusing the model, or maybe it's...
I'm stuck at the gate, and they won't let me
through. Just the two of us anymore.
See you soon.
Find a way to vanquish the spirit. So this is where I apparently killed some of my loved ones. Interesting. I really wish I know how to vanquish a fucking perhaps a book on the occult will help. Thanks. Real helpful.
Don't be afraid. I'm only going out for 2 hours. If Maggie can't sleep, just read her this book. It works every time. I'll be home before you know it. Dinner's in the oven.
I clicked away. Love you. I clicked away. Thank you. Demon, thank you for coming by as always. Hope you have a lovely evening. A book on the occult. Alone in the Mansion? Write a prayer of cleansing in the text file, then save it. The spinning hard drive will act as a prayer wheel. What the fuck? Alright, it's obviously nothing right in here. Let's go look for it. Oh, shit. Now the real nightmare begins. All of her posters are gone. Nothing. Just the bathroom, don't need it. That's a scary fucking picture. That looks like my sleep paralysis demon. Garage, attic. Well, one of them's close. Baby. Everything's just fucking destroyed in here. It's what the house actually is, but I thought it looked like something else. That's so fucked. Still going. There's really nothing else around here. I just have to go down. Yeah, I get it. It's spinning. This is not awesome. You stop it right now. Murder, suicide. Stabbed several times from laying face down and upstairs. Her service passenger passed before the arrival. Process for the case of Sarah's husband, Gary Pout. Police weren't able to question him as he was also found deceased. So I'm also dead. Why do these houses never have power? Because this is my hell. Or something like it. Because I too am dead. I can't get out through that door. A book on the occult. Something you just usually leave around. Vonage manuscript, that might be it. The Great Beyond, the Vampire Menace. The New World of the Arcade, preparing for Fallout. A Mind Without a Mind, HPB Cookbook, and How to Draw. And what does that say? It's like missing a part of the book up there. What the hell? Ooh, shit, I wanted to do that. Oh. No. I don't want any of that anymore. Great game. God. Oh, motherfucker. Hello, Diz. Welcome to the party, Diz. Let's all give a shout out to Diz and laugh at him because I guarantee you anything, it's going to be a video of him screaming. Okay, it wasn't that scary. But yeah, go follow Diz. He's a dick. It's all about dicks. Dicks! Now, what's this one? I mean, cool, I guess, but where the fuck's the shit about the occult? All around the corner jump scares you? Oh, damn it. Let's try the Great Beyond. Okay. What about the real person as he is or was? The halls are filled with the ghosts of his past. It sounds like me. Such memories were happy to remind her of how precious life really is. So, he realized that she was here for a reason. He was supposed to see her experience an epiphany. Her chief memory of what had to come before. Took lessons learned when you've done something wrong. So what had he done to deserve a lesson? Killed my fucking wife. It's amazing how so many items don't spark memories. He picked up a single innocuous object and spark a flood. A simple gift from his wife reminded him that he was not only married, but he was married to someone that truly deserved a person much better than he. Pace your heart, sir. Brother Chet, his beans hurt. It's a midsummer shit, yeah. Is this a dream? Am I going to wake up as another person? This can't be right. I feel like I'm prying through someone else's stuff. I'm so strong and vivid. It's the trick of the mind. A part of the dream designed to make me forget I'm dreaming. I guess it must be at the solid dream. And as he continued to rummage through his things that seemed to belong to another, he came across a photograph of his wife. He didn't recognize her at all. He was struck by her beauty. He could tell she was full of life, caring, giving, intelligent. As he looked close to the image, trying his hardest to memorize her face, and there was something strange. I was waiting for a picture to be right there. I'm not sure like the details of her features, the blur of the image became. It was almost like it was being blocked somehow. Probably after I noticed that her face had been scratched out of the image. Well, was that there before? Am I going insane? Something happened to his wife, but what? Whatever it was, his mind didn't seem ready to remember. This sparked a deep fear in him. He knew at this point that something terrible had happened, but he couldn't reach it. He was watching the deep anxiety, the kind where butterflies are in your stomach and an invisible hand squeezes your throat. He continued to explore the house, half expecting to come across something awful. Where was his wife? Why couldn't he remember her face? He found something in the living room and something looked off. One of the front windows was open, but there was something very strange about it. Walking through the window, he stuck his hand through to the outside. It dawned on him. There was no breeze, no smell, no atmosphere whatsoever. Middle of the night, and he couldn't hear the chirp of a single cricket. Look at the sky. He noticed the clouds were rolling much faster than they should, and it looked like they were moving in reverse. The neighborhood was totally dark, except for one house in the distance with a light in the window. Paul didn't see what was going on. He walked outside, headed for the house with the light on. He waited for what seemed to be hours, looked up at his destination, realizes he hasn't gotten any closer. Turning back, he noticed he was still in the front lawn of his house. He turns to look at his destination, and suddenly he was teleported to the front door of the mysterious house. Teleporting might be the wrong description. It was more like the house came to him and was built board by board right in front of him within a second. He turns to look back where he came from and saw nothing but darkness, broken only by a slow rolling fog. In the absence of other choices, he knocked on the door. Upon upon the third knock, the light in the house went out. He waited a moment before deciding to try the knob. It was open. He crossed the threshold, looked behind him to close the door, but was shocked to find the door gone, replaced by a solid brick wall. This must be a dream, he thought. I don't even feel like me. Am I going to wake up from this nightmare and see someone else staring back in the mirror? That's when it happened. The answers he was looking for were right in front of him. Oh my god, what is this? I can't read anymore. No. Fuck. Alright, what about this one? Alright, this isn't the occult. The vampire slayer? Yeah, it's not helping. I'm trying to find how to get rid of this fucking bitch. Traditional lasagna, fluffy pancakes, spaghetti and meatballs, southern fried chicken. Hey, you know what? That's a pretty good cookbook. Oh, the drawing's that easy, huh? Yeah. I can't draw any of that. Oh, yeah, wait, look at this. Fuck, I forgot. Oh. Okay. Sulfur or sulfur. This painting is wild. Giant dude in that huge boat, and then like three smaller boats. One with like a present on it. What is that? Nope, I don't want to watch TV. I was just messing around, bro. Tapes all over the fucking floor now. Oh. That doesn't look good. Okay. Back here at the front. Nope. Running out of fucking options. I'm getting scared. Yo. That's the picture. Oh. This is so fucked. I mean, I get it, but it's fucked. That's not good. But yeah, shut the power off on us. I can't light the candles. I wish I could. I can't bring the lighter with me anywhere. The fuck?
Listen up. We've got some news hot off the presses. Tragedy has struck Pleasant Falls. A woman was found murdered in her home. She was brutally stabbed over 10 times.
I know.
The victim's name was Sarah Powell. Sarah managed to make a call to 911 before she succumbed to her injuries.
Yes, PT.
The primary suspect of this brutal murder is believed to be her husband, Gary Powell. He was found deceased only mere blocks away, slumped over the steering wheel of his car after a fatal collision with a tree. The murder weapon was found in the car with him, leading investigators to speculate that he crashed his car while fleeing the scene of the crime.
Or
a daughter believed to be 19
maybe
years of age. Successful in tracking her down.
Fuck,
if anyone
bitch
knows the location, please contact Pleasant Falls PD immediately. It is also believed that Sarah has been victim to domestic abuse. If
oh
you
my god. Just host me because it just played another clip and that scared the fuck out of me. No, it's not your bad. Thank you for the host. I just always forget to write something that there's a host in the chat. I always fucking forget.
Someone you know is suffering from domestic abuse. Get help before it's too late. Listen up. got some news hot off the presses. Tragedy has struck Pleasant Falls. A woman was found.
Enough of that. I fucked up, okay? I was a bad person. Or I was set up, one or the other. I don't actually know. I'm just playing stupid. Let me have it. I need this knife, though. Chef Meister 2 series. Very nice. Tons of dog food. Wait a minute. How is the fridge on if the electricity's off? Also, the time? Why is that off? You guys. Hey, rat poison. Let's just drink that. Very nice. Very evil. Alright, take it easy, man. Enjoy your trip tomorrow. Hope you have a good time. Some stuff over here. Dog grooming. Oh, I found it. All right, this has to be it. It's like a 72D house full of trash and canned foods. Demons and gods, magic wielders, the undead, mythical creatures, ghosts and entities, plants and vegetation, elementals, gnomes and fairies, scorecards and notes. I'm going to go with entities because I'm pretty sure that's where we need to be. Page 28, here we come. God. I can't turn the page anymore. What the fuck? Okay, I guess I can only read the introduction. Oh, it's a tabletop game. God damn it. I was like, I found it. It's homage to Errol Otis with the artwork. Huh. God damn it. Farmer's Market. Big Jim's Appliance. All seeing eye security. Baby shower. The water board. What the fuck? Slow pot. Plumbing services. Oh, she was a witch for Halloween. 1985. Dear Gary Ryan Powell, we would like to extend this offer of employment for the position of security guard with all seeing eye security. Please read the summary of terms and conditions for your anticipated employment with us. If you accept this offer, your start date will be August 15th, 1981, or another mutually agreed upon date. You will report to Shane McFarlane. I'd plow my driveway when it snows. I mean, duh. Please find below the terms and conditions of your employment should you accept this offer letter. Until I be junior security officer, you will report to the regional security manager. Full-time position while you are employed at this company, you will not engage in any other employment, consulting, or other business activity, whether full-time or part-time, that would create a conflict of interest with us. By signing this letter of agreement, you confirm that you have no contractual commitments or other legal obligations that would prohibit you from performing your duties for all eyeing eye security. All seeing eye security. The company will pay you a starting salary at the rate of $6,271.20 per year. In 1999? Oh, no. It's 81. Why would the calendar say 1999? Am I way in the past? What the fuck? Per year, payable in accordance with our standard payroll schedule. This salary will be subject to adjustment pursuant to our employee compensation policies, in fact, from time to time. The company reserves the right to terminate employment of any employee for just cause at any time without notice, without payment, and without notice. The company come with the intel to terminate your employment for any reason other than for just cause upon providing to you such minimum notice as required by law. Sincerely, Nathan Babylon, whatever. Gary Pout. Well. Okay. So I had a job. I don't want to watch TV. Thank you. See, look. Unless I kept that paperwork from that long ago. Oh, this door opened. Oh my god. Jesus, get the fuck out of me. Who is he? My thoughts are dark, black as night. Life is sparse, total absence of light. When it's all over, come find me there. Broken soul, I belong nowhere. I feel better today. Oh.
June 6th, 1999. My hands are shaking as I write this. Maggie's gone. Michael's gone. And Gary's gone too. At least the man I love is. It's just me and the monster living inside Gary. And the beatings are getting worse and I'm running out of excuses. So tired. The lady next door came over yesterday. She must have heard something. She urged me to call the police, but I just can't do it. I love Gary so much. He's never gotten over Michael leaving us. And he blames me. Maybe it is my fault. All he does is drink, locked in that basement day and night reading those weird books. He's so unhinged now.
Of course, in the basement.
What do I do? I can't abandon him.
Indeed.
I know Gary's in there somewhere and I'll be right here when he surfaces again. Fuck, this is so hard. I have to stay strong for him.
Become one with the reflection. Jesus Christ. So yeah, they lost their kids, clearly. And husband didn't take it well. I mean, neither did obviously the wife didn't take it well either. Of course not. I'll fight. Hello? I love you, honey. The bad man did it, not me. Remember? Oh my god. I look in the mirror, I see only a husk. Yikes. She's caught, fuck. Fuck me, dude. I got it. I'm sorry, who's that? I'm sorry, who? I can't hear you. I can't let go of the phone. Because it was ringing. Why would I not answer the phone? It's very important. Okay.
Oh,
Jerry. Oh my god, it's the basement. It's where I need to go. Can I take it? No. No. Like, give me one of these fucking tools, please. Calling about your car's extended warranty? Yeah. Like, it won't let me take any of these things to use. Oh god, what have I just done? Oh. What the fuck? I'm in the reverse world. The door leads to the Visage House. Stop it. Mirror, mirror, on the wall. What the fuck have I just done? Up with all the pictures, like layers of fear shit now. Everything is in reverse. I'm in the upside down. I don't want to know what those are. I wanted to pull all the fuses and cause a problem. Jesus. Where do I go? Alright, I'll stay away from the fucking hole. Jesus Christ. Oh boy. Read the book, say the words. I agree. The spells contained within this book are your pathway to power beyond your human ability to imagine. Excuse me, I'm speaking. For once you to learn the intricacies of wielding such power, the book and the rites within will no longer be needed. Your body and soul will become a conduit for the darkness. Dark power energy will be transformed through you into an object or focused on a task. You'll give direction to those energies, their agent on this plane of existence. That does not mean this book should be taken lightly. Its contents are dangerous. You should always be treated with respect. Party Rock is in the house tonight. Colloquium. To meet the dead, one must open their minds to the ghost that fills the head. The world of the specters and the world of the flesh are separated by a thin veil, held only by faith and a false head. Which can yourself over and will stand astride both worlds. This long is not enough to speak with the specter, it will soon be open to you. For a scripture will need to be performed for you can summon the specter to you, even your death does not care for you or your aspirations.
Well then.
Performance and rituals are forbidden in most cultures for this reason. An earth lifetime is but a passage out in the face of eternity. Keep this in mind when you summon the dead. Jesus Christ. I'm gonna cut you with a sharp knife. The rite of scripture, huh? Ritual of sacrifice. This ritual is often used in conjunction with other rituals to complete a rite. First, you will need to find a living creature. Any creature will do. The larger the creature, the more effective the ritual. Face south and chant Atheria me tadera tol anima mea. Repeat these words for the remainder of the ritual. Drain the life from the creature into a receptacle until it has crossed over. Drink every last drop. This concludes the ritual sacrifice. And we're going to make you lose your mind. Yay! So wait, which one am I supposed to do again? Write his scriptures. lives are born in violent deaths. This is... What is going on here? Oh, I guess this is the one I needed. Oh, rite of passage. So, yeah. Angry spirits are born in violent death. To set the spirit free, you need to perform a ritual. For this ritual, you need to gather the following objects belonging to the angry spirit. Body of the deceased, any part of the remains. Image of the deceased. Clothing worn in the eyes of God. So, wedding dress. An object of ancestral significance. Once collected, cleanse the objects with fire and spread the ash over the site where they were slain. First, makes the most of the gold. Yes, that's the one. I am not going to remember how to do that. Supposed to get around her. I have no light source. My flashlight doesn't fucking work.
A woman was found murdered in her home. Stabbed over 10 managed to make a call to 911. Have been victim to domestic abuse.
Monster living in Pedozzi's drink.
Maybe it is my fault.
Yeah, abandoned here so much.
I see. So I am stuck in like limbo. Find some of her remains. Yeah, see? I was supposed to die there and then I come back to life because I'm already dead. Alright. So where are we gonna find this? She just had to go to the bathroom, leave her alone. Speaking spell. Where would some of her remains be? Mommy. Be down here soon. Well, I thought she was gonna go to the potty. What happened? Teddy bear. Oh. Grabbed that once. Grab that too. Oh. Okay. That's nice. Quite scenic. Very strong storm door. Cabin in the woods. Definitely nothing scary about that. Yes, a woman out for a nice evening walk through the meadow. And she's going to the church. And now she's standing by the beach. Now she's just kind of hanging out in the woods. And now something happened. It looks like she got someone's getting stabbed. There's some knife. Yeah. Oh God. She's in a house. Now she Opeth's next album cover. at a grave with a little crow on it. She's outside. Where is she in this picture? I don't see her. Weird. And back to the start. Well, that was terrifying. I did not like that one bit. Should have shut the door. So she saw him. I'm dead. She started moseying really quick, so I was gonna dick around with that. I feel like I'm gonna suck at this game. That on. I don't think it's that easy. I can't get out of this room.
Jesus help me. No, I'm tapping out of this for tonight. Holy fuck. Oh, no. Oh. I need to look up, like, tips on this game, because I'm going to suck at it. I can already tell. I'm not good at these styles of games. Clinching and static is indicator. No, I get that. I had no time to move. There was absolutely zero time. The idea is I just want to keep, like, going through my backlog, and I don't want to give any game more than, like, a solid day or so. So I'll leave this game installed. I'm probably just going to move to the next one. I mean, not tonight. Yeah, I actually may just bail a little early tonight, now that I think about it, because I got fucking video editing to do. I don't want to start anything too fresh. So, excuse me. Without further ado, Jesus, awfully gethy. That was definitely entertaining. I mean, it definitely was. The atmosphere in that game, even when, like, the house was normal. In the beginning, I was like, this is fucking creepy. I already don't like it. And it just kept getting worse and worse. Now this bitch is in there. Yeah, it is. I will say that. And I appreciate you coming out, sir, as always. So for everyone else, I'm going to send everybody right on over to the good old Heavy Hand Swings. Good night, Mr. Fathom. Thank you for being here and scaring the absolute shit out of me earlier. So yeah, Heavy's playing some Valorant. He's very good at it. Probably good music too in between games and whatnot. So yeah, I'm gonna send everyone over there. Yeah, it was an A+ job for sure. So I'm gonna send everyone over to Heavy. If you haven't followed him yet, definitely follow him. Great dude. Love the guy. And I think D&D might be off tomorrow, considering the tree is getting on a bus to New York City. So maybe I'll be back tomorrow. We'll see. Until then, take it easy.
Jugg. For a ride.